Itraconazole is an antifungal agent used for the treatment of various fungal infections in immunocompromised and non-immunocompromised patients, such as pulmonary and extrapulmonary blastomycosis, histoplasmosis, and onychomycosis. In this video, let's find found. What is itraconazole? What is itraconazole used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking itraconazole? How does itraconazole work? How to use itraconazole? What is itraconazole? Itraconazole, sometimes abbreviated ITZ, is an antifungal medication used to treat a number of fungal infections. This includes aspergillosis, blastomycosis, coccidioidomycosis, histoplasmosis, and paracoccidioidomycosis. It may be given by mouth or intravenously. What is itraconazole used for? For the treatment of the following fungal infections in immunocompromised and non-immunocompromised patients: pulmonary and extrapulmonary blastomycosis, histoplasmosis, aspergillosis, and onychomycosis. What is itraconazole used for? For the treatment of the following fungal infections in immunocompromised and non-immunocompromised patients: pulmonary and extrapulmonary blastomycosis, histoplasmosis, aspergillosis, and onychomycosis. Side effects: decreased urine output, dry mouth, fever, increased thirst, irregular heartbeat, loss of appetite, mood changes, muscle pain or cramps. Pharmacodynamic: itraconazole is an imidazole/triazole type antifungal agent. Itraconazole is a highly selective inhibitor of fungal cytochrome P450 sterol C14 alpha demethylation via the inhibition of the enzyme cytochrome P450-14 alpha demethylase. This enzyme converts lanosterol to ergosterol and is required in fungal cell wall synthesis. The subsequent loss of normal sterols correlates with the accumulation of 14-alpha-methyl sterols in fungi and may be partly responsible for the fungistatic activity of fluconazole. Mammalian cell demethylation is much sensitive to fluconazole inhibition. Itraconazole exhibits in vitro activity against Cryptococcus neoformans and Candida spp. Fungistatic activity has also been demonstrated in normal and immunocompromised animal models for systemic and intracranial fungal infections due to Cryptococcus neoformans and for systemic infections due to Candida albicans. Mechanism of action: itraconazole interacts with 14-alpha demethylase, a cytochrome P450 enzyme necessary to convert lanosterol to ergosterol. As ergosterol is an essential component of the fungal cell membrane, inhibition of its synthesis results in increased cellular permeability, causing leakage of cellular contents. Itraconazole may also inhibit endogenous respiration, interact with membrane phospholipids, inhibit the transformation of yeasts to mycelial forms, inhibit purine uptake, and impair triglyceride and/or phospholipid biosynthesis. Half-life: 21 hours. Dose: aspergillosis. Indicated for treatment of pulmonary and extrapulmonary aspergillosis in immunocompromised and non-immunocompromised adults who are intolerant of or refractory to amphotericin B therapy. Sporanox: 200 to 400 mg/day PO, used in combination with corticosteroids. Talsura: 130 mg PO q-day or bid. Onychomycosis: indicated for treatment of onychomycosis of the toenail due to trichophyton rubrum or T. mentagraphytes in non-immunocompromised patients. Nails: Sporanox only, 2 treatment pulses, each consisting of 200 mg Q12HR for 1 week. Pulses are separated by a 3-week period without Sporanox. Toenails: with or without fingernail involvement, Sporanox, onmol, 200 mg per day, PO for 12 weeks. Safety advice: itraconazole is rated FDA pregnancy category C, risk of human teratogenicity with oral itraconazole may be lowest of the systemic antifungal agents because itraconazole has little effect on steroid hormones. Antifungals, azole, systemic. That's all the information about itraconazole we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.